गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स, यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम टू थिंकाइज चैनल। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग द कुरुक्षेत्र मैगजीन। आवर टॉपिक इज एजुकेशन, द बैकबोन ऑफ डेवलपमेंट। एजुकेशन द बैकबोन ऑफ डेवलपमेंट। ऑथर इज सराह अय्यप। इन इंडिया सोशल सिक्योरिटी हैज़ बीन अ प्राइम फोकस एरिया अक्रॉस वेरियस प्लान्स एंड पॉलिसीज ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट। ओवर द लास्ट टू डिकेड्स और सो देर हैव बीन अ मेजर स्लू ऑफ मेजर्स in sync with the need for greater recognition to social and economic rights. Education is considered as a backbone of development and is recognized as one of the most important instruments to alleviate poverty and reduce inequality. It can guarantee social security with ripple effects across other critical dimensions of human development through its correlation with improvements in health, strengthening the democracy and ensuring good governance. With rapid economic growth and social development in the last few decades, India has witnessed considerable improvements in health and education as well as falling poverty rates. However, as is true in most parts of the world, the fruits of economic growth tend to accurate disproportionality to a small section of society. However, as it true in most parts of the world, the fruits of economic growth tend to accrue disproportionality to a small section of society. Consequently, increasing inequality has been a massive drawback of our growth story. The top 1% of India's population holds 3/4 of the national wealth, while the bottom 60% owns less than 5% of the country's wealth. Approximately 26% of the people are illiterate. Over 90% of the nation's labor force works in unorganized informal sector, and over 1/5 of India's people live below the poverty line. Social security. The rationale: the poor tend to be the most vulnerable, facing greater risk and insecurity from health problems. Structural adjustments to the economy, globalization, climate change, and natural calamities. To ensure that the benefits of economic growth trickle down to the poorest section of society and alleviate poverty, social security programs are critical. The term social security broadly refers to guarantees that secure protection for the people, poor and vulnerable, preventing or eliminating exclusion. In India, social security has been a prime focus area across various plans and policy of government. Over the last two decades or so, there have been a major slew of measurements in sync with the need for greater recognition to social and economic rights. These measures include a plethora of schemes covering both basic services and social benefits like access to public health, education, sanitation, and food security, as well as minimum income support. Most of these programs are aimed at addressing deprivation in capability, low educational attainment, inadequate nutrition, etc., rather than providing safety nets to deal with contingency risk such as health shocks or death. Such social protection helps with the absorption of shocks, minimizing adverse impact on the vulnerable and making the growth process more equitable. Social security and education. Education is considered as the backbone of development and is recognized as one of the most important instruments to alleviate poverty and reduce inequality. It can guarantee social security with ripple effect across other critical dimensions of human development through its correlation with improvements in health, strengthening the democracy, and ensuring good governance. India has made massive strides in improving indicators related to education as evidenced in the table 1. What is table 1? Trend in elementary education in India. In the decade between 2008 and 2020, the gross enrollment ratio and transition rates surpassed the 90% mark. The dropout rate almost quartered, and facility-based indicators reached near universal coverage. The number of schools having electricity almost tripled in the last 10 years. Trends in elementary education in India indicator. Enrollment-related indicators. Gross enrollment ratio 2008-9 82.5%. And 2018-19, 91.64%. Transition rate from primary to upper primary level, 82.7. 2018-19, 90.36. Dropout rate, 2008-9, 8. And 2018-19, 2.72. Facility indicators, percent schools with drinking water, 87.8 in 2008-9 and 89.97 2018-19. Percent school with girls toilet, 53.6 2008-9, 95.86 2018-19. Percent school having electricity, 35.6 2008-9, 96.25 2018-19. What is the source? Source is Unified District Information System for Education, UDISE, Unified District Information System for Education. The upward trend in the status of Indian education are a result of consistent efforts by the central and state governments. Programs. Efforts of the government have continuously reflected the key role of the state in providing minimum levels of employment, education and food as basic elements and entitlements for the citizenry. In fact, the Constitution of India adopted way back in 1950 contains all the ingredients for the states to move towards the realization of socio-economic rights. This forms the very foundation for the right-based approach behind the design of India's welfare system, ensuring social security by administering greater power to the underprivileged and building an equitable society. A lot of measures taken are complementary in nature, and the article distills its focus on the major interventions undertaken till date. First is midday meals. Based on the initial success of school meals in states like Tamil Nadu, the central government wanted to expand its coverage through the national program of National Nutritional Support for Primary Education, NPNSFPE, launched in 1995 under the program Dry Rations. Monthly quotes for wheat or rice were distributed to students. Responding to a public interest petition on the rights to food on November 28, 2001, the Supreme Court directed all states' governments to initiate the provision of cooked midday meals in primary schools. Over the next 3-4 years, school meals were in place throughout India. Since then, the quality and menu of the meals has been steadily improving over time. The objective of the school meals program is to boost efforts to universalize education by increasing enrollment, retention and attendance while improving nutritional levels among children. Classroom hunger irrefutably impacts learning. A hungry child is less likely to attend school and is more susceptible to illness. Simultaneously addressing food security and education, the scheme helps children from disadvantaged communities to collectively combat hunger, poverty, and illiteracy. The largest feeding program in the world, the midday meal scheme impacts around 100 crore children in India by contributing to better nutrition, enhancing school participation, improving learning outcomes, and increasing social equity. For some children from the most vulnerable groups. These meals are often the only source of food during the day. The scheme, while achieving its objectives, also has significant gender-related benefits. By employing over 25 lakh cook-cum-helpers, it creates job opportunities for local women and reduces the economic burden on poor households. The scheme is perhaps one of the India's most successful and cost-effective measures and is hugely created for the improved status of education. For the fiscal year 2020-2021, the scheme has been provided a budgetary allocation of rupees 11,000 crores, amounting to almost 20% of the total budget for centrally sponsored schemes in the school education. Second is the Integrated Child Development Services. The Integrated Child Development Services ICDS scheme, one of the flagship programs of the Government of India, is the largest program for promotion of maternal and child health and nutrition in India. It was launched in 1975 in pursuance of the National Policy for Children. It provides nutrition, health and preschool education to children under the age of 6 through child care centers or Anganwadis staffed by local women workers or helpers. These centers offer food, games and regular health checkups for younger children. Weekly or monthly take-home rations, THR, are provided along with health services like immunization or vaccination. The scheme also provides nutrition and health services to pregnant women, lactating mothers and adolescent girls. The ICDS was first stated in 1995, and in 2006, a Supreme Court declaration came into force establishing that all children under 6 years of the age are entitled to ICDS services as a matter of right. The subsequent expansion of ICDS has led to an accelerated improvement in anthropometric indicators of child nutrition as well as child vaccination and institutional deliveries. With a target coverage of 15.8 crore children between the age of 0 to 6, the scheme represents the largest unique early childhood care and education program in the world, currently offered through over 14 lakh Anganwadi centers. Given that the highest economic returns accrue at the earliest stage of education, the scheme significantly contributes towards ensuring a strong foundation of learning. In the fiscal year 2020-2021, the umbrella ICDS scheme got a whopping allocation of INR 28,557 crores, which is over 95% of the budgetary allocation to centrally sponsored schemes of the Ministry of Women and Child Development. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Since the 1990s, the government focused on the universalization of education through centrally sponsored schemes like Operation Blackboard and state initiatives such as the District Primary Education Program, DPEP. These paved the way for the launch of the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, SSA, in 2001, with clearly defined targets for achieving elementary school enrollments and retention. The program supported the setting up of a new school in habitation that did not have schooling facilities and the provision of additional classrooms, toilets, drinking water, maintenance, and school improvements grants. It also focused on strengthening teaching resources through extensive training, grants for developing teaching learning materials, and ensuring academic support at a district, block, and even cluster level. It sought to provide quality elementary education, including life skills, with a special focus on education of girls and children with special needs, CWSN, special focus on education of girls and children with special needs, CWSN. The core focus areas including access and retention, infrastructure development, equality, and providing quality education. In 2009, The program guidelines were subsequently revised to support the norms, standards and free entitlements mandated by the Right to Education Act, RTE 2009. As of 2017, the scheme was serving 19.2 crore children across more than 10 lakh habitations. In 2018-19, the unit budget proposed an integrated approach to school education, aiming to treat the school education space from pre-nursery to class 12 holistically as a continuum. The government subsumed the SSA for elementary education, the Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan RMSA for secondary education, and the scheme for teacher education into the Samagra Shiksha scheme, catering to all 25 crore school students. SSA is Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. And teachers education scheme is Samagra Shiksha scheme. The major objective of the scheme include enhancing learning outcomes of students, bridging social and gender gaps, as well as ensuring equity and inclusion at all levels of school education, ensuring minimum standards in schooling provisions, promoting vocationalization of education, supporting states in implementing of right of children to free and compulsory education RTE Act 2009, and the strengthening and upgrading of nodal agencies for teacher training. The budgetary allocation to the scheme for financial year 2020-2021 is almost 40,000 crore Indian rupees. Fourth is the right to education, initially recognized as fundamental right by the Supreme Court in Mohini Jain versus Union of India 1992, SCC 666. The right to education was enshrined as the law in following years. The right to education is directly linked to the right to life under the Indian Constitution. As the Parliament passed the 86th Amendment of the Constitution in 2002, Article 21A was instituted in the Fundamental Rights section, declaring free and compulsory education to all children between the ages of 6 to 14 years, following a detailed process of comments and deliberation on several drafts of the Education Bill. With the Union Cabinet stamped its seal of approval in 2008. Subsequently, the Right to Education Act was passed in Parliament on August 4, 2009, coming into force from April 1, 2010. This was a landmark moment in the Indian history, as the country joined the pool of around 140 countries that declared education as a fundamental right. In addition to free and compulsory education, the right to education also requires a pupil-teacher ratio of 30:1 for every primary schools and 35:1 for every upper primary school. While providing for infrastructure improvements, it also ensures that parents or guardians do not bear any direct costs for uniforms, textbooks, meals, transport, etc. Education is completely free till a child completes elementary stage of schooling. Fifth is draft national education policy, laying the foundation for the future of education. The draft national education policy NEP 2019 is due to be released shortly. The policy envisaged an India-centric education system which contributes to equitable and sustainable transformation by providing high quality education for all. The National Education Policy NEP aims to provide early childhood care and education for all children aged 3 to 6 by 2025, ensure universal access and retention across all levels of school education, and 100% youth and adult literacy by 2030. Further, it calls for placing the students and teachers at the center of all reforms, improving school governance, expanding the midday meal program, and strengthening the right to education. Its effective implementation is imperative to strengthen the extent social security measures. Sixth is Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan. The COVID-19 pandemic forced the closure of over 15 lakh schools and 40,000 higher education institutions, serving as a credible threat to social security, disrupting the learning process. While unprecedented, the pandemic has disproportionate consequences on the social fabric, with the most adverse effect on the poor. As the creamier layers of society have shifted to online modes of learning, the digital divide is exposing threats to equitable access to education. The coronavirus establishes a case for furthering social security measures, exposing greater vulnerabilities among people within the system. To ensure minimal disruption to learning, the central government has identified critical interventions, formulating a relief package. As part of the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, the Prime Minister announced a special economic and comprehensive package, signaling a clarion call for a self-reliant India. Education has been identified as one of the core sectors, with the main post-COVID theme of technology-driven education with equity. PM E-Vidya, a program for multi-mode access to online education, will be launched shortly to include facilities to support school education in states and union territories under the Digital Infrastructure for Knowledge Sharing, Diksha, D-I-K-S-H-A, Diksha, One Nation, One Digital Platform program. Extensive use of radio and podcast is being envisioned, along with the use of television. Towards this end, one channel per class is being considered through the SWAYAM, S-W-A-Y-A-M. 1 year of Modi 2.0, impetus to tech-based learning with PM E-Vidya, multi-mode access to education through online platform to benefit nearly 25 crore school children. Diksha Portal, D-I-K-S-H-A, Diksha Portal, providing quality e-content for school education and QR-coded energized textbooks. SWAYAM, S-W-A-Y-M, SWAYAM online courses in MOOCs, M-O-O-C-S, MOOCs format for school and higher education. 1 year marked TV channel per class from 1 to class 12. Siksha Vani, extensive use of radio, community radio and CBSE podcast. Special e-content for visually and hearing impaired on Digitally Accessible Information System, DAISY, in sign language on NIOS website or YouTube. Impetus to tech-based learning with PM E-Vidya. PM E-Vidya, a program for multi-mode access to online education, will be launched shortly to include facilities to support school education in states and union territories under the Digital Infrastructure for Knowledge Sharing, Diksha, One Nation, One Digital Platform program. Extensive use of radio and podcast is being envisioned, along with the use of television. Towards this end, one channel per class is being considered through the SWAYAM Prabha direct-to-home television platform. For CWSN, e-content is being designed for the visual and hearing impaired. Over 200 textbooks have been added to the digital repository e-Pathshala. The Ministry of Human Resource Development, MHRD, is also working on the Manodarpan, an initiative to provide psychosocial support to students and families for mental health and well-being. The National Council for Educational Research and Training, NCERT, is developing a new curricular framework for schools and teachers with a special focus on early childhood, and by December 2020, a national foundational literacy and numeracy mission will be launched so that every child attains predefined learning outcomes in grade 5 by 2025. 1 year of Modi 2.0, 1 year. Expanding horizons of digital education. Manodarpan, a portal for providing psychological support to students, teachers and families for mental health and emotional well-being. Top 100 universities to start online courses, online component in conventional universities and ODL programs to be raised 20% to 40% to provide learning opportunities to nearly 3.7 crore students. New national curriculum and pedagogical framework for school education, teachers education and early childhood stages to prepare them as per global benchmark. Expanding horizon of digital education. In addition to these major programs, the government also has the scholarship and other dedicated schemes for girls, selected communities, minorities and CWSN students. In fact, in an effort to ensure the fruits of growth reach the 112 most backward regions of the country, the Aspirational District Program was launched in January 2018 to promote convergence of the scheme, collaboration across levels of the government and drive competition among the districts, home to about 14% of India's population. The Aspirational District Program focuses closely on improving people's ability to participate fully in the burgeoning bourgeois economy, facilitating inclusive growth for all, sabka saath sabka vikas. Education is a core programmatic focus area in addition to health and nutrition, agriculture and water resources, financial inclusion and skill development and basic infrastructure. Challenges. Though the development trajectory in the education has been positive, there is still a long way to go. The National Sample Survey Office, NSSO 2014, estimated that 3.2 crore children up to the age of 13 have never attended any school. The dropout rate worsens with grade progression and at the secondary level it is almost 10%. Further, quality of education remains a major concern. The Annual Status of Education Report, ASER, ASER 2018, reveals that nearly 50% and 27% of the students in grade 5 and grade 8 respectively cannot read a grade 2 level textbooks. Even the government's competency-based National Achievement Survey, NAS NAS, conducted by NCERT in 2017, cautions grade level competencies to be as low as 40 to 50% across subjects. Extrapolations from a cross-country comparison across diverse countries on human development parameters related to education also highlights India's relatively lower status of education. The gross enrollment ratio at the pre-primary stages in China is over 6 times that of the India. The expected and mean years of the schooling is lower than other countries with starker differences for females. The share of government expenditure on education is also lesser. Norway, with the highest score of the United Nations Education Index, spent twice as much as India in terms of the percentage allocation of the gross percentage allocation of its gross domestic product GDP. Way forward. While the record of social security measures in education varies between states, there is a large pool of evidence suggestive of its importance contribution to human welfare. There remains ample scope to extend these efforts and create strong policies driven by evidence and drawn from international experiments. It is hoped that extended debates on enhancing social security, such as universalization versus targeting, continue to contribute to efforts to augment the foundations of social protection in India. Addressing challenges to social security through education requires action on three fronts. First is the need to address the fiscal challenges. Mobilizing additional resources by increasing the tax to GDP ratio is critical to ensuring a stronger education system. Second, the design and the dimensions of various schemes need to be carefully re-examined and evaluated, along with a scoping exercise detailing necessary course corrections. Third, there is significant potential to increase implementation efficacy through enhanced accountability and proactive measures to reach the most vulnerable section of society. Quality education is critical to sustainable development, with a decade left to achieve goal number 4 of the sustainable development, and estimates suggesting India will be home to the largest working age population. It is imperative to strengthen the social security net by addressing some of the current issues now. This is essential to catapult India's development journey. Footnotes: Oxfam report, Public Good or Private Wealth, 2019, Census Survey, 2001, the World Bank. The author is a young professional at Niti Aayog, Sarah Aipe. Here we are having a table, a cross-country comparison in school education. Indicator, overall performance on Human Development Index, HDI, Education Index score, India 0.558, Norway 0.919, USA 0.899, China 0.649. India is lowest. HDI score 0.647, India, which is very low. Norway 0.954, USA 0.920, China 0.758. HDI rank, India 129, Norway 1, USA 15, China 85. Relative performance by ranking, India low, Norway highest, USA high, and China medium. Second is access. In access, we are having some major points. First is gross enrollment ratio, in which pre-primary, primary, secondary, primary school dropout rate. Pre-primary, India 14, Norway 95, USA 72, China 86, India is at lowest. Primary, 115 India, Norway 100, USA 101, China 102. Secondary, India 75, Norway 117, USA 99, China 95. Primary school dropout rate, India 12.3, Norway 0.9, USA not available, China not available. People teacher ratio, primary, India 35, Norway 9, USA 14, China 17. Survival rate to the last grade of lower secondary general education, India 94, Norway 99, USA and USA not available, China 92. Third topic is equity. Equity consists of expected years of schooling and mean years of schooling. In expected years of schooling, male and female, there are two categories. In male category, India has 11.9, Norway 18.8, USA 15.7, China 13.7. Female, India 12.9, Norway 17.4, USA 16.9, China 14.1. Mean years of schooling, there are two categories, male and female. In male category, India has 8.2, Norway 12.5, USA 13.4, China 8.3. In female category, India 4.7, Norway 12.6, USA 13.5, China 7.5. Our next topic is infrastructure. Here, percentage of secondary schools with access to internet. India not available, Norway 100, USA 100, China 98. Governance, primary school teachers trained to teach. Primary school teachers trained to teach, India 17, Norway, USA and China not available. Government expenditure on education as a percent of GDP, India 3.8, Norway 7.6, USA 5.0, China not available. Source, Human Development Report 2019, United Nations Development Program, UNDP. Thank you very much.